My name's Ed Komen. I'm the acting chief of police for the Kern High School District Police Department.
What happened?
Well, at about 10 o'clock, we received a report that there was somebody armed with a gun either in front of or on the campus at Arvin High School. Of course, we responded, got a lot of help from the allied law enforcement agencies. We locked down the school, did a perimeter of the school, and did a very systematic, thorough search of the entire campus to include all the classrooms. And we've determined that that's not true. There never was somebody with a gun on the campus. And we've cleared the campus and we'll be releasing the students here shortly. No one's been injured. And we can assure you that it's safe now.
So what is this situation? I mean, with this reporting witness, did she appear to be a credible witness? Did she truly think she saw this and she didn't? Or what do you think?
It's very early in the investigation, so it's hard for me to say decisively. Initially, it appeared credible. And so, of course, we treat it as such. And the investigation will continue to find out why that was reported to us.
Regardless, it seems like quite a bit of rumors spread here and really added to the hysteria. I mean, I talked to numerous people who were on the phone with students inside, and the students were saying there's two men with AR-15s and we've heard shots fired. So all of this is just, you know.
Very much so. The story feeds on itself. Social media doesn't help in that regard. And so when I came out to the crowd, I was kind of surprised at some of the rumors that were circulating.
So is there do you have any clarification as to what people did see, if they thought they saw a gunman? Was there any ever suspicious person on campus? Or what happened?
The initial report was that there was somebody with a gun, a handgun, who was in front of the school and then possibly went onto the campus. Through our preliminary investigation, we've determined that to not be true.
So you said you cleared the classrooms. How were there any other steps that you took to make sure that this 100% was not true?
We've checked every inch of the school.
Can you tell us a little bit about who else responded here? I mean, obviously, just SWAT.
Well, I hate to forget somebody, but we had a lot of help, of course, from Arvin Police Department, from the Kern County Sheriff's Office. California Highway Patrol was here. The FBI lent us some assistance. And Kern County Fire was here. Unfortunately, there's probably a couple that I'll forget.
Can you tell me your message? Again, as Louis said, we've been talking to concerned parents all day, all morning, who've been getting texts from their students inside. Just your message to those concerned parents who are waiting.
The message is, we received the initial report, we thoroughly investigated it, we locked down the school, ensured everybody was safe, and we determined that there was never anybody with a gun on the campus. Now we're going to hear rumors because of social media, and these are high school students. Trust me when I say, no shots were fired. There was not a gun on the campus. Everything was safe. We went to the nth degree. It's a high school, and it's crucial that the students are safe, and so that's why we went to this extreme.
You just touched on, but can you speak a little bit more to why it is so important? I'm sure a lot of people are going to say, wow, that's a lot of people to call out if it was not even real. Why do you take such extreme steps in situations like this?
Well, because it's a high school. And initially, of course, you treat it as if it's 100% true, and you take every possible conceivable step so that everybody's safe, and that's what we did. Yes.
Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Well, it's very typical, probably in all of society, but particularly at schools. One student will send a message to another that will get embellished. And before you know it, we have a mass event on our hands when, in fact, we didn't. Never did.
Do you have information on who called this in? Was it an administrator, a student?
No, it was a member of the public.
And will there be a continued police presence for the rest of the day, week?
We're going to release for the rest of the school day. Of course, we'll have a little more police presence here. And yes, there will be an elevated presence for the rest of the week.
Can you dissuade any rumors that all the schools in this area were put on lockdown?
As far as I know, amongst the Kern High School District, this is the only one that was placed on lockdown. There was no threat to any other school. In fact, we now know there wasn't a threat to this school either.
There was a hack in social media, a specific Snapchat that I saw. Here that had up on their phones, a what looked like somebody with a gun in the parking lot? Could that have been just a member of the law enforcement that was at service school? Have you seen or heard anything about that?
I don't know yet. I've been at the command post the whole time. I haven't seen any of the social media, but we had a wide variety of law enforcement here, some of them in civilian clothes, so it's entirely likely.
Okay. And the parents seem to get here amazingly quickly. We have lockdowns in Bakersfield all the time. They don't result in thousands of people showing up at the school.
It's a close community, and we did send out a notification to the parents.
How do you send out that notification? Is it like a reverse 911 call? Is it a letter, an email?
All our schools have a system, an all call, where it's an automatic system. You send a message and it automatically calls all the parents.
And what did that message say, actually?
I'm not sure. It was a notification of what was occurring, and that if you wanted information, please come to the park. We initially had school personnel and some of our officers at the park to dispel rumors and let people know what was going on. But as you can see, they didn't stay at the park and they came over here.
Is this the most serious false alarm we've had in Kern County regarding a potential school shooting?
Well, a few years ago, you recall Taft High School had much worse. That's coming to my head initially.
But this is, would you consider this the worst false alarm? You know, there was a chance that there was an active shooter on campus, but...
We treat them all as seriously as it warrants. We be as safe as we possibly can. So we've had similar reports before, but in other instances, we're able to establish it didn't happen or immediately find the person that was being reported. In this case, it just stayed unknown for a long time.
So has a situation similar to this or reports like this happened in Arvin in the past?
Probably none that I can think of off the top of my head.
So currently school's on lockdown, but that'll be released in the next 20, 30 minutes, you said, right?
Probably sooner than that. In fact, as soon as I leave here, that's what we're going to do.
Okay. So the search is completely over?
The search is over.
Are they going to be dismissed in any organized way, or is it just going to be like...
There will be quite a few students coming right through here, and the parents will be meeting them. That'll be occurring within just a short time.
Let's get to it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.